Hello, welcome again. We are solving some conventional questions of compulsory computer topic is Ayatan topic group question number 29 from Civil Services Mains 2022 is air Cp is equal to 1.05 kJ per kilogram per day Kelvin, gamma is equal to 1.38. Air 3 bar pressure at P 600 Kelvin is flowing with a velocity of 180 meter per second inside 20 cm diameter duct. Calculate 1 mass flow rate, 2 stagnation temperature, 3 Mach number, 4 stagnation pressure assuming the flow to be assuming the flow to be 1 compressible and 2 incompressible. So here first of all we have to calculate mass flow rate, and mass flow rate is rho AB and rho is density and pressure is given and temperature is given. So density is P by RT. So P is 3 bar. P is given as 3 bar and temperature is 600 Kelvin. So it is 3 into the power of 5 divided by 27, R is 27 divided by temperature is 600. So that will be 1.742 kilogram per meter cube. So density is this. And area of the duct is, diameter of the duct is 20 cm, so the area will be 420 by 100 km. And velocity is given as 180 meter per second. Okay. So mass flow rate will be here, rho AB, that is 9.85 kilogram per second. So next is stagnation temperature. Final stagnation temperature will balance heat, kinetic energy and heat energy. So at stagnation condition the kinetic energy is zero, so there will be only thermal energy, so that will be Cp T naught. And in the moving fluid both kinetic energy as well as thermal energy will be there, so it will be Cp T plus Cp plus Cp T plus V square by 2. Or we can take this Cp here, so here it will be T only and here it will be V square by 2 Cp. So now we have temperature 600 Kelvin, V 180 meter per second, Cp is given as 1050. So or 1.05 kilo. So the stagnation temperature comes out as 615.42 Kelvin. And Mach number is active velocity by sonic velocity, and sonic velocity is root gamma RT. V is your 180 meter per second, and gamma is 1.4, R is 27, and T is 600. So Mach number comes out as 0.366. So next is stagnation pressure. If we assume compressible flow, then we can apply the isentropic condition to find out stagnation pressure. So that is P naught by P is equal to T naught by T, gamma gamma n minus 1. T naught is stagnation temperature, PT is a static temperature, P naught is stagnation pressure, P static pressure. And this is 615.42 and this is 600. And gamma is given as 1.38. So it comes out as 1.09. And P initial pressure is given as 3 bar. So multiplied by 3 bar, we get 3.289 bar. So this is when we assume compressible flow. When we assume incompressible flow, then we can apply Bernoulli's equation to find out stagnation pressure. So that is, at stagnation condition the velocity is zero, so there will be no velocity yet, and assuming that rate of is same, and so it will be, the Bernoulli equation will be like that, P naught by rho g plus P by rho g plus V square by 2g. So rho g will cancel out, g will cancel out, and rho can come here because rho at the initial and final condition will remain same because rho is incompressible. So P naught will be equal to P rho V square by 2. P is 3 bar or 3 meter per 5 Pascal. Rho is 1.742 and V is 180 meter per second. So P naught comes out 328 0.4 or 3.28.